द बेस्ट क्रिसमस प्रेजेंट इन द वर्ल्ड पार्ट 3। आई फोल्डेड द लेटर अगेन एंड स्लिप्ड इट केयरफुली बैक इनटू इट्स एनवेलप। आई केप्ट अवेक ऑल नाइट। बाय मॉर्निंग आई न्यू व्हाट आई हैड टू डू। आई ड्रोव इनटू ब्रिटपोर्ट, जस्ट अ फ्यू माइल्स अवे। आई आस्क्ड अ बॉय वॉकिंग हिज डॉग वेयर कॉपर बीचेस वॉज। House number 12 turned out to be nothing but a burned out shell, the roof gaping, the windows boarded up. I knocked at the house next door and asked if anyone knew the whereabouts of Mrs. Macpherson. Oh yes, said the old man in his slippers. He knew her well. A lovely old lady, he told me, a bit muddle-headed. But at her age, she was entitled to be, wasn't she? 101 years old. She had been in the house when it caught fire. No one really knew how the fire had started, but it could well have been candles. She used candles rather than electricity because she always thought electricity was too expensive. The fireman had got her out just in time. She was in a nursing home now, he told me. Burlington House on the Dorchester Road, on the other side of town. I found Burlington House nursing home easily enough. There were paper chains up in the hallway and a lighted Christmas tree stood in the corner with a lopsided angel on top. I said I was a friend come to visit Mrs. Macpherson to bring her a Christmas present. I could see through into the dining room where everyone was wearing a paper hat and singing. The matron had a hat on too and seemed happy enough to see me. She even offered me a mince pie. She walked me along the corridor. Mrs. Macpherson is not in with the others, she told me. She's rather confused today. So we thought it best if she had a good rest. She has no family, you know. No one visits. So I am sure she will be only too pleased to see you. She took me into a conservatory with wicker chairs and potted plants all around and left me. The old lady was sitting in a wheelchair, her hands folded in her lap. She had a silver white hair pinned into a wispy bun. She was gazing out at the garden. Hello, I said. She turned and looked up at me vacantly. Happy Christmas, Connie, I went on. I found this. I think it's yours. As I was speaking, her eyes never left my face. I opened the tin box and gave it to her. That was the moment her eyes lit up with recognition and her face became suffused with a sudden glow of happiness. I explained about the desk, about how I had found it, but I don't think she was listening. For a while, she said nothing but stroked the letter tenderly with her fingertips. Suddenly, she reached out and took my hand. Her eyes were filled with tears. You told me you would come home by Christmas, dearest, she said. And here you are, the best Christmas present in the world. Come closer, Jim dear, sit down. I sat down beside her and she kissed my cheek. I read your letter so often, Jim, every day. I wanted to hear your voice in my head. It always made me feel you were with me. And now you are. Now you are back. Can you read it to me yourself? Would you do that for me, Jim dear? I just want to hear your voice again. I would love that so much. And then perhaps we'll have some tea. I have made you a nice Christmas cake, marzipan all around. I know how much you love marzipan. By Michael Morpurgo. Students, in the third part of the story, the author, Michael Morpurgo, having read the letter, he puts it back in the envelope. He decided to give the letter back to whom it belonged to. The address was Bridport, Dorset. So he drove to that place. The house number 12 turned out to be a burnt-out shell. It was found that Mrs. Macpherson was in the house when it caught fire. The fireman had got her out just in time. She was 101 years old. Now she was in a nursing home. The author went to the nursing home. He met the matron. She told the author that Mrs. Macpherson was rather confused that day. They had put her in a conservatory. The author found Mrs. MacPherson sitting in a chair. Naturally, she looked up at the author vacantly, but her eyes lit up when he called her Connie and gave her the letter. He told her how he had got the letter, but she was not listening to him. She reached out and took his hand. Her eyes were filled with tears. She felt that her husband Jim had returned. She said that he had kept his promise. He had returned on the eve of Christmas. She made him sit beside him. She kissed his cheek. She talked long and lovingly with him. She said that she had got the best Christmas present in the world.